Hi, I'm Dr. Michael Breus, the sleep doctor. I'm a clinical psychologist and board certified sleep specialist. And welcome to video 5 of my sleep series dedicated to helping you get quality and deep sleep and operate and function at your best. In the previous video, I talked about blue light, which is found in all of our televisions, light bulbs, computers, and phones. And I talked about how blue light exposure in the hours leading up to bedtime is destroying your ability to get good, deep sleep. And there are actually a few simple things that you can do to start limiting your blue light exposure before bed, like shutting down all your electronics about an hour before sleep, cooling the house down before going to sleep as well, wearing blue light filtering glasses like the sleep doctor glasses 90 minutes before going to bed, or listening to soothing music. Now let's talk a little bit more about music and how it can be a wonderful tool to help you get better sleep. First, multiple sleep studies have shown that listening to music at bedtime improves sleep quality in young adults, older adults, and in children, can help improve sleep quality for adults with insomnia, and can help you fall asleep more quickly. In a recent study of healthy adults, research demonstrated that listening to relaxing music reduced feelings of anxiety, as well as the physical symptoms that can accompany anxiety. These symptoms would include things like elevated blood pressure and heart rate, and nervous system arousal. When we find ways to relieve stress and improve our mood, our sleep almost always improves. In addition, music has also shown to improve sleep efficiency. That's the measurement of time that you spend actually asleep compared to the overall time you spend in bed. Lower sleep efficiency can be an indication of restless sleep and awakenings throughout the night, trouble falling asleep at the beginning of the night, or waking very early and not being able to fall back to sleep. By improving your sleep efficiency, you just improve your overall sleep. Another interesting finding that the sleep study researchers discovered was that the therapeutic effects of music on sleep actually get stronger with time, meaning the more consistently you use the music to help you sleep, the more effective the practice may become. You basically start conditioning your body to recognize that when relaxing music is played, the body should get ready for sleep. But what is the right kind of music to listen to before sleep? Just as the different colors of light affect us differently, so does the type of music you expose yourself to. While we learned in the last video that it is good to expose ourselves to high levels of blue light during the daytime to stimulate and focus us, we also know that upbeat music excites us and makes us want to dance. Consequently, we don't want to listen to Eye of the Tiger right before sleep. Thank you all for joining me again and learning about how different types of light and music affect us and our sleep, and how we can harness the power of both to get great sleep when we want it and be focused, rested, and alert when we want. Keep watching this series and learning all of the many tools that I have to share so you can get better sleep. Remember to subscribe to this channel and tell your friends about this series so they also can achieve a great night's sleep. Be well, I'll see you next time. This is Dr. Michael Breus, the sleep doctor, wishing you sweet dreams.